Since both HTML and JavaScript have some essential ambiguity, we needed to handle that before we could move farther with our web browser. But now that we know a bit more about grammars and ambiguity, we can actually move on to making grammars for HTML and JavaScript. And just to remind you, here's an example HTML utterance, "Welcome to my web page." Here, I've drawn a relatively simple grammar for a surprisingly large subset of HTML. One of the first challenges that we'll have to deal with is that a web page can have a list of words like "Welcome to my web page." So our starting non-terminal, HTML, has a recursive structure. Using this rule, HTML goes to element HTML, we can apply rule 1 over and over again to get as many elements as we need. Maybe 1, 2, 3, 4 for welcome to my web page. And then eventually when we're done, replace with epsilon or the empty string. An element can either be a word, like welcome to my web page, or the beginning of a nested tag. So here, tag open and tag close are a lot like open parenthesis and close parenthesis. Whenever we make one, we're going to make the other. And then in here, tag open is angle bracket word close angle bracket, and tag close is left angle slash word right angle. So for example, this part matches a tag open, and this text matches a tag close. Now actually, as it stands, I'm only allowing a single word to be inside any tag. And inside these bold tags, we've got quite a lot of stuff going on. Let me show you the power of a recursive grammar. Oh yeah, watch this trick. Now at the top level, an HTML document is a list of elements, as many as you like. Each one of those elements may themselves be a tag. And inside tags, we have another list of elements, another, in essence, entire web page. So here at the top level, we just have one tag open for bold, but inside it, there are four elements, the word welcome, the word to, the tag open for my, and the word for web page. I'm going to draw the parse tree for this utterance using our grammar. I'm going to use ELT to abbreviate for element. I'm going to use TO for tag open and TC for tag close. Now, I've only drawn or sketched out a small portion, maybe about half, of this parse tree. But we're still going to be able to see how things match up by comparing the leaves. Remember, a leaf is a node without any children, to what we saw in the original string. Here, my first leaf, working my way down and to the left, is this open left angle bracket, and that matches up here. My next is this B, matches up here. Matches up there. And then, after that tag open, there's an HTML, which is an element list, and the first one is the word welcome. The next one is the word to. Now, although this tree structure is cumbersome for us, it's very convenient for computers because it tells us exactly which part of the tree to draw or to apply in a certain manner. It might not be obvious which word should be bolded or which word should be italicized. But if I have a tag open and a tag close, this entire subtree is influenced by this tag. How much of the web page is bolded? Exactly this part over here. The bold's great, great uncle or something like that. Right? Go up a few, over one to the right, and then back down. We're going to use this special structuring to help write our web browser.